Hello and welcome back. I am sharing with you three more blank journals that I have listed now in my shop. Two of them are tropical paradise themed journals like this one, and on this side there's the other one, and I have one that is bee themed. I show this then at the end, but I start with the first tropical paradise themed journal. It has 60 pages front and back. It doesn't look like very thick and much, but it has 60 pages. And it will grow and get much more stuffed and fluffy as soon as you put ephemera into this. They are also made to make it your own. So I include this ephemera here, and then you can use whatever you like from your own stash. You can keep it for yourself, or maybe you think about Christmas and you have a friend or family member, a loved one who likes this theme, tropical paradise, or maybe someone wants to travel next year. Think about that. Maybe that's an idea for you. I show you the ephemera. There are lots of journal cards that came with this kit. I've purchased it from TLC. I've used here the original size and then also printed them half size. So lots of large journal cards. You can use them as journal cards, or you can also make pockets or tucks out of them if you wish. And just be creative. I think we have all the imagination and we can craft crazy. So the second one is very similar. Yeah, I have shrunk down these cards so you have more possibilities. Use them as tucks, as pockets, or as an embellishments. You can also use, for example, one of these cards and use this as focal point on a tag. And then I included also the tag pockets. Here you can see already a blank tag that fits here into this pocket. So you can work a little bit more. Then this is cardstock. So cute. This is a fold-out pocket. As you know, I like to use them in my journals. When I embellish them, I glue them here, here, and here on three sides. Glue it to a page, and then I have more pockets. Here you can put something in there. You can put something here in there and behind, and you can also fold out this sheet completely. And it says this music envelope that I made here, and I have included blank tags. So, and the journal looks like this. That's one of the pages, and I've used it as a focal point. And this is the cover. This is cardstock. In between, we have a piece of file folder, and on the inside, we have fabric. But this here is cardstock. That's just so sweet. This is an organza ribbon that is completely removable, and it opens up like this. This fabric was off-white, and I have colored it a little bit with different colors. I don't know if the camera can pick it up. So it has lots of different colors in there. Matches the colors here. This is your coffee stand paper, but on the other side we have a napkin. This is a napkin. This you can see it here. This was the size of a napkin, and then we know the four sides are mirrored, and I have ironed it on the coffee stain paper. I have used a piece of a plastic sheet, a thin, the kitchen roll. You know, the kitchen roll from plastic to wrap fresh food in there. I had the coffee stain paper, then I placed very, very a thin piece of this plastic roll, and then I have put this napkin on top, then a sheet of baking paper, and then I have ironed it, and so this sticks with the plastic on this coffee stain paper. I hope that makes sense. So here we have different sizes and colors of paper. This is a vintage book page. I have, because it's so very fragile, I've reinforced it with tropical themed washi. Yellow coffee stain paper with a pattern here, this diamond. This is cardstock. I've sprayed it on the back side with coffee. Different page, a mere vintage music. This is again a napkin, same concept. I have ironed it on coffee stain paper, and I've distressed it. Cheap parrots. This green coffee stain paper. So very, this is a blank journal, but I think you can make it your own. This is a Spanish book page, a vintage book page in Spanish. Again, a napkin ironed onto coffee stain paper. So you can go, for example, let me show you. You can go now, for example, with this fold-out pocket, glue it here on three sides onto this page. So, and then you can embellish here this fold-out pocket also, and you have a space to put something behind or here or here. It's just an idea. That's the center. Here I let the strings again longer. If you don't like it, cut them short. Other side from the napkin, the Spanish page. Here the other side from the napkin. And this is the fold out from the cardstock. And here the other side from the napkin that I have ironed onto this coffee stain paper. So lots of room for writing and playing with it and to make it your own. Goes with this journal. So here we have the next tropical themed journal, different cover, same concept. I did not knew that I have this cardstock, and when I printed this kit out, I thought, oh well, oh wow, well, I can use it. It's the same kit. But different arranged. Here also napkins on ironed on coffee stain paper. A green coffee stain paper. It turned here a little bit yellow and green, and that matches perfectly to this kit. Another piece of cardstock. I saw a different piece. Vintage book page with washi tape. This napkin on coffee stain paper. So I may can make here very quickly because it's similar to the other one. And this is the center. Oh, I'm in a frame, yes. Oopsie. So you can stuff it as full as you wish. This napkin on coffee stain paper, Spanish page. Again, this napkin. So that's very, very similar to the other one, but a different cover, and the pages are different arranged, so it's not totally equal. And here again, the ephemera blank tags, also this envelope that I made from the vintage music sheet with the acetate here, window, folded pocket, triple pocket. Oh, the other one has no triple pocket. I will include it. I have here triple pocket that comes with the other one also. Sorry about that. tag pockets, and here again, all the journal cards in different sizes. So they have a lovely start to make this also your own. Here are all the little ones. You can also make paper clips out of them. And here again from the cardstock, some tags. And I have distressed it. So that comes with this journal. And here we have now a bee-themed journal, a little bit different. This is printed on 160 GSM photo quality paper. I've sealed it with Mod Podge, so soft. And in between there is the file folder, and then on the inside the fabric. So bee-themed, also blank journal. See. Sorry about that. So now I fold it out. So now we have it. It's completely removable. One signature, 60 pages, bee themed. I have colored this fabric. Coffee stain paper, Edith Holden page. This is from the German version of an Edith Holden book. Coffee stain paper, music sheet, bees. This is a vintage. I have an encyclopedia, and I have used a page with bees. So now, if you are now scared of bugs, then you should now stop the video. On the back side there are bugs, but I wanted to include this because here of the bees. If you don't like the bugs, cover them up with a piece of paper, whatever paper you want. So if you don't like them, you can just really easily cover them up. I like them. I like bugs. A yellow coffee stain paper. Spanish book page, reinforced with washi. This is a book page from England is a Garden. Lined yellow. Okay, wait. Lined paper. And I have inked it. No, I have coffee stained it and then inked it, so it is yellow. Very grungy coffee stained. Here's the center. Again, it's longer. If you don't like it, cut this off. Bees. So again, fold out. Here the thistle, Spanish page, again fold out. This is a vintage book page in German. Here again the bugs, if you don't like them. You can use a piece of cardstock, for example, and glue it here so you have a side pocket. And then you don't see them if you don't like them. But here are the bees again. The other set from the Edith Holden book page. And that's it. This is the bee themed journal. So they look thin. So at 60 pages front and counted front and back is not less. And here I have a triple pocket. Here this vintage music fold out. This is this one because you have the numbers, and then it folds up this way. It's a grungy envelope. Here I have two fold out pockets in yellow and in green, but coffee stained. The tag pockets, and then it comes with a lot of this ephemera. So here is much more ephemera than in the other two tags, more tags and tags. And then we have journal cards. Oh, again a tag. So you can clip the things onto the pages, you can glue them. You can also use, for example, a journal card or two as a pocket or as a tuck if you just glue two sides. More bees, much more bees. Bees. Or you use this here maybe for as a belly band. And we have bingo cards. So I put it for the moment behind the journal, but I will pack them properly. So these are the three journals for today. Different same concepts. Mod Podged, sealed with Mod Podge, and these are cardstock with different images here. Pretty cute. I hope you like it. I hope to see you soon. There's more. I have another video. Three more journals, and I've made really 12 journals for this series. And I hope you like this idea to get a journal for a lower price with the ephemera that you can make this journal your own. You can embellish the covers more if you wish. You can put your own stuff in there. You can prepare slowly for Christmas maybe and give them later to your friends and family members. So go to my Etsy store. The link is in the description box. Check out the other journals that I have there. And I hope you like it. I hope to see you soon. Thanks for watching. Have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.